Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. How does the sun work? For the better part of a century, the scientific consensus has been that a nuclear reaction within the sun causes the sun's light, heat, and radiation. But rather than confirming this model, modern space discovery has only provided seemingly endless riddles and anomalies. Nevertheless, today, institutional science gives no indication of its readiness to explore real theoretical alternatives in solar physics. In this episode, Bishop Nicholas Sykes contrasts, in clear and simple terms, the fundamental differences between the electric universe paradigm and the standard view of the sun and all stars.
Video number 6, The Workings of the Sun. The currently generally accepted model of the Sun, as well as other stars, operates on the premise that it functions as a nuclear furnace. The electric universe paradigm offers a radically different theory of the workings of the Sun, as has already been indicated in these Space News videos. I would like now to sow some further seeds of doubt in viewers who are content with the current generally accepted model of the Sun, before going into any further detail about the electric universe paradigm. We should first note that what has become the nuclear furnace model of the Sun was developed by theoretical researchers in the years between the First and Second World Wars by Sir Arthur Eddington at a time when the theory of relativity was beginning its dominance. Soon after this, scientists and engineers began to be greatly impressed by the proposed new applications of nuclear technology, both for peaceful purposes and to the ends of war. Furthermore, it has by now been assumed for many years that it will just be a matter of time and a refining of research to discover some way of controlling the process of nuclear fusion, which is at the heart of nuclear bomb production. When a nuclear bomb explodes, the nuclear reaction is said to be uncontrolled. There is no ability to slow it down or have it produce a smaller amount of power over an extended time. To discover and master controlled nuclear fusion has been an aim of scientists and technologists for over 6 decades, with the incentive that the basic fuel for it is plentiful and readily available. It was never envisaged when nuclear technology began that the tough nut of controlled fusion would prove to be such a hard one to crack, and so nobody had any qualms about modelling the sun on just this basis. Not being, obviously, an ephemeral phenomenon like a hydrogen bomb, here today and gone tomorrow, if the sun is to be modelled upon nuclear fusion, it must be a controlled fusion furnace that can continue producing energy for many millions of years. Electric universe theorists have noted that the nuclear model of the sun had its beginnings in a time when physicists were turning away from the experimental verification of their thought-based models. And indeed, Albert Einstein's work was a prime example of this. Eddington himself became the chief supporter and expositor of relativity in Britain. Previous videos have noted how the corpus of Einstein's work achieved almost universal acceptance without any experimental component in its conception. And such verifications as have been claimed for it are now under severely critical scrutiny from an increasing body of independent scientists. It is not surprising, therefore, that the proposed nuclear model of the Sun achieved rapid general acceptance without an adequate experimental or observational basis. After this model was generally accepted, physicists tried to verify it, perhaps most famously, by trying to detect the neutrinos that such a nuclear reaction in the heart of the Sun would have to produce. They found that there were for sure some neutrinos found to be emitted by the Sun, which can be taken to be verification that there are nuclear reactions occurring there, but not anything like the number that would have to be produced if practically the whole radiant energy of the sun were actually produced by nuclear reaction. Considerable theoretical fancy footwork on the nature of neutrinos is to this day going on to try to resolve the deficiency problem. But there are other unexplained features of the sun too that should cause most serious doubts about the validity of the whole model. An educational website has stated, the core is extremely hot. Under these conditions, nuclei that would normally repel each other fuse together instead. In the core, hydrogen joins together to make a helium nucleus. This releases positrons and neutrinos and radiation energy called gamma ray photons. The fusion in the sun's core also creates 99% of the sun's heat or thermal energy. The rest of the sun becomes warm when the heat created by fusion moves outward from the core through the layers outside. There is one huge unstated problem for this model, presumed as factual by many textbooks and websites. The observation, as opposed to the widespread contrary presumption, that by far the hottest part of the sun is not within the core, where the assumed furnace would have to be, but outside of it at the corona. An international team of researchers points out that the deepest observable surface of the sun yields a temperature of about 6,000 degrees Kelvin. As we peer into the darker interior of sunspots, we see cooler regions, not hotter. But moving outward to the bottom of the corona, the temperature jumps spectacularly to almost 2 million degrees. Thus, the superheated shell of the sun's corona reverses the expected temperature gradient predicted by models of internal heating. It is clear that an internally heated furnace of any sort, nuclear or otherwise, does not and could not work this way at all. The sun's temperature gradient, increasing where a furnace model would predict a decrease, is given an explainable cause by the electric universe model. And this ought to make the EU model a realistic contender for the minds of scientists and the general public. Indeed, it ought to make the electric universe paradigm an irresistible contender for research opportunities in the science departments of any new university that was brave enough and ultimately to be proved wise enough to take it on.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.